In this video, we are going to learn about evaluation metrics. In the previous video, we have studied about linear regression and we have studied about train test split, which is an evaluation metrics. Now, in train test split, we were dividing our data into test and train. And after dividing, we perform machine learning model on the data, that is on the train data. And we check the values of our test data. And then we make a comparison between the actual test values and the predicted test values. Now, only with that information, we cannot decide about the performance of the model, whether the model is good or bad. Hence, we need more evaluation metrics. So, in this video, we are going to deep dive into evaluation metrics. Before we deep dive into evaluation metrics, let us understand what exactly does evaluation metrics do. Evaluation metrics are used to measure the quality of the statistical or machine learning model. Now, it is very important to find out whether our test values and predicted values are very close to each other. If they coincide with each other, then we can conclude that our model is performing in the best possible manner. If they do not coincide with each other, then we can say that our model is a weak model. It is not able to predict the future values accurately. Hence, we need evaluation metrics to check the quality of our machine learning model. Before we go into the evaluation metrics, we have to understand on what this evaluation metrics is based on. So, it is based on nothing but our error. Now, what exactly is this error? The error is nothing but the difference between actual values and predicted values. Now, if you observe on your left hand side, you have a simple linear regression. The blue dots that you see over here, these are your actual values, that is your actual data points. And the red line that you see over here is the predicted values. Now, we want most of the points to either lie on the red line or lie very close to the red line. Why? So that it will improve the accuracy of our model. So, error is nothing but the difference between the blue points and the red line. Now, let us understand what is mean absolute error. Mean absolute error is the mean of absolute values of the error. In the previous videos, we have understood why we are taking an absolute value of the error. High probability of event that errors could be positive and negative. In such a scenario, these errors would cancel each other out and our error would be zero, which is not a correct value for us. Hence, to avoid the cancellation of error terms, we use the absolute values of the error. Mean absolute error is given by the following formula: 1 upon n summation of I is equals to 1 up to n yi minus y hat, where yi is your actual y values and y hat is nothing but your predicted values. Now, let us look at the next evaluation metrics. The next evaluation metrics is nothing but the mean squared error. The mean squared error tells us how close a regression line is to a set of points. It does this by taking the distances from the points to the regression line. These distances are the errors and squaring them. It is more popular than mean absolute error because the focus is more geared towards larger errors. This is due to the squared term exponentially increasing large errors in comparison to smaller ones. The formula for mean squared error is given by MSE is equals to 1 upon n summation I is equals to 1 to n yi minus y hat, where your yi is nothing but your actual values and y hat is nothing but your predicted values. Now, the next evaluation matrix is nothing but your root mean squared error. It is the standard deviation of residuals or prediction errors. Residuals are a measure of how far the regression line data points are. RMSE is a measure of how spread out these residuals are. In other words, it tells you how concentrated the data is around the line of best fit. The formula for root mean squared is given by root of 1 upon n summation I is equals to 1 to n yi minus y hat the whole squared. The best part about root mean squared error is its interpretability. The units for RMSE is similar to the units for y. So it becomes really easy for us to interpret the RMSE. I hope root mean squared error, mean squared error, mean absolute error is clear for one and all. Thank you.